Hi, everybody. Wanted to just say hello and share a little of God's word with you today. We all need a little comfort every once in a while. We all need to be reminded that we can't fix things. And that's kind of the basis of today's study. Based on Romans 11:33 through 36. Oh, the depth and riches and wisdom and knowledge of God. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgments, and how inscrutable are his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord? Or who has been his counselor? Or who has given him a gift that he might be repaid? For from him and through him and to him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. How often do we find ourselves thinking we know exactly what's best for us? I've done it. I'm sure you have too. I know what's good for me. I know what's worked in the past. Sometimes God's plans change. Sometimes things aren't always the best thing for us that we think, you know. It may seem like the easier path. It may seem like the righteous path, but God's plans don't always follow ours, do they? Probably more often than we'd like to admit, we think we know exactly what's best for us. But in Romans 11, it speaks to our pride, our foolish tendency to think that we can figure things out on our own. It proclaims that God's greatness, wisdom and ways are far above our own. There is no greater wisdom or knowledge than that of the Lord, and everything on earth shows this truth. Now, understanding God's greatness exposes our frailty and fickleness. When we humble ourselves by proclaiming his greatness, we set aside our pride and make space to learn from him. We declare that God is sovereign above all things, and we can easily see his glory and grace. The more we realize that God is in control, the more readily we shift our trust in ourselves to our trust in God. That provides far more comfort than trusting ourselves ever could, because we know that we fail, and yet God is perfect. We'll never have all the answers, but we know the one who does. We can walk confidently and joyfully through whatever comes our way, whether we're in the hills and we're having a perfect time, not having any issues, right? And it looks like we're on top of the mountain. God is there beside us. Whether we're in that deep, deep valley and we are struggling and we're trying to climb our way out, but God will meet us in that valley, and he will be the one to help us out. We can't do it on our own. I wanted to share just a part of a song with you, just for a little encouragement, to help remind you that God is walking with you. Okay? So just listen real fast to this. Just part of it. When I'm standing on the mountain, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I know I am not alone. Your God over hills and valleys, hills and valleys, God over hills. That's Taryn Wells. His song is called Hills and Valleys. It says, when I'm standing on the mountaintop, I didn't get there on my own. When I'm walking through the valley, I'm not alone. Your God of the hills and valleys, I'm not alone. Check it out. It's a pretty cool song, and it's a good reminder. We are not alone. Aren't we lucky? Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you. I thank you for not leaving us alone, for walking through this life with us, through the best times and the worst of times. Lord, remind me today of your greatness. Humble me. Help me and teach me to trust in your word. Lord, I am so grateful for that. I am grateful for the fact that you loved us so much that you sent your son. And Lord, I just pray that these words will be an encouragement to someone out there today. And I pray that you will wrap your loving arms around those who need that comfort today and embolden us and give us strength and courage to share your love to those around us, to bring others into your fold. I am so glad you are in control. Thank you, Lord Jesus. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Have a wonderful day, friends.